I was kind of trying, I was going to go through what's in the book real quick. The first part is going to be my PowerPoint presentation. And the second part is the proposed budget, and it just goes through, it gives a glossary of terms, in case you need to know, our mission statement, our ADM. It has the salary schedules in here. I think at the meeting Thursday, this is our schedule, salary schedules from this past year with the 4% added. But when we were monitoring, the monitoring people talked to us about upping the salaries for transportation and trying to get them to the state minimum. And so I think we're going to put that on the agenda. We're going to keep, this will be what's current. And so we'll put that as a separate line on the agenda Thursday. So, you know, we can, but I'll put some more information on that. And I also put what the state allocation sheet that they gave us, and then our ADM. And then behind that is broken down by schools, what they gave for each schools, for salaries, benefits, how many FTEs we got. And then behind there, I put a B report, which is, you can pull that from the state's website, but to me, this is an easier report to read than the P reports behind it. The P reports are like broken down by every which way. So, anyway, that's what's in the book. If you have any questions about it, you can ask me. So this is our proposed budget for the 2020 year. So budget is just pretty much an estimate of what we think our revenues and expenses are going to be for this upcoming year. I try to be very conservative on my revenues and try to be more liberal on my expenses. But the funding that the state gives us is based on the 20 days after Labor Day. So, you know, they take this week account and use that to determine how much money they're going to give us. So what we're getting this year is based off of last year's number. So if you've got a class that's got way more than what you think, but last year's number they didn't, that's why you all have allocated off of last year's numbers. This is just the budgeted revenues for the general fund, special revenue, debt service, capital projects, and expendable trust. That's going to be on your B report, which is right before the reports, and you can find those numbers. General fund being the biggest revenue we have. Special revenues is going to be all of our federal funds, along with some of the local school funds, the public funds. Debt service is something we get from the state to pay our debt, and then we get some capital projects, which has our flip renewal and our PSF money in it. Our expendable trust is going to be our non-public funds at the local schools. This is just a breakdown of the revenues by funding source. So the state, we're getting $14.5 million, the federal $2.5 million, local $5.6 million, and then others, $59,400, and total $22.8 million. And then some people just, it's easier to look at a chart than it is to look at numbers. So the majority of our funds are coming from the state, followed by our local funds, and then a portion from the federal. And the other ones are in that little bitty tiny, you know, I didn't even notate it because it's so tiny. The general fund. This is what the state looks at to see if we have our 1 month balance. So I have projected that we're going to end the fund, that our ending fund balance is going to be a little over $1 million, which is going to put us at
I have a motion to adjourn?